Howdy folks, and welcome back once more to Let's Play Doom, Ultimate Doom, whatever. We're shooting dudes, we're gonna keep shooting dudes, and after that I have a feeling I'm probably also going to shoot some more dudes. And maybe some form of hell spawn, I guess. We'll see. Anyways, how you guys doing today? I'm doing pretty well. I'm shooting dudes. Feels good, man. Some nice, easy, thoughtless violence. Which is kind of a terrible thing to say, but hey, here we are. Alright. Ooh, sneaky sucker. I'm coming for you. You just gotta wait for the elevator. Ooh. Oh! Alright. I would say that was a skilled shot that I managed to kill both of those dudes standing abreast in there, but I'm not gonna lie to you guys, that was pure luck on my part. What? What? Ah! I was gonna say, I know there's one more of you suckers up there. I think there's still one, like, lurking. That's okay. We'll get him later. Oh, I just aggroed a bunch of stuff in there. So another fun little fact about Doom is that the way the monster AI works in this, you can change their, like, default standing behavior, and it's how the developers do, like, ambushes and stuff. Monsters have a couple parameters to them. You can make monsters that are deaf, and if a monster is deaf, most monsters, if they hear you shoot your gun, they will go to, like, their hostile mode, and they'll start, like, meandering about looking for you to murder you. And there are ways you can get around, like, that triggering enemies. One is to set up line defs on the map as if they block sound, which, after I murder this dude. But you can see there's that little brown line right in front of me on the map here. That is a line def, and in this case it's used to just kind of, like, drop the ceiling down here. But you could also set it so that line def blocks sound that goes past it. And if that's the case, like, you could shoot a gun right next to a monster, but so long as the monster's on the other side of that line def and has its back to you, it won't hear you, it won't notice you. The other way is that if you set a monster as deaf, and then regardless of... Ooh, we got a rocket launcher, nice. Regardless of how the sound travels, it won't hear it, so it has to actually have line of sight to you to flip hostile. And so that's kind of used for, like, doing stuff like ambushes, having monsters, you know, waiting on the other side of corners and stuff. It's kind of clever. It is a good way to, like, kind of give the illusion of the monsters being smarter than they really are. Something that, like, a good example would be, like, Fear, the game, the old PC game Fear, where, like, a lot of people praise that game's AI, and it's not so much that its AI is necessarily smart, it just has, like, a lot of pre-programmed triggers that'll happen as you play through the game that makes the AI do things that seem like they're smart. Like, you might trigger a zone on the map that makes the AI, like, spawn in behind you, but then they'll have, like, an audio bark that they do that's like, yeah, you know, unit 2, move to flank, and then you're like, holy shit, these things are smart enough to move around and flank me, which they're really not. The game's just giving you the illusion that they are. It's quite fascinating. And you can, well, I mean, you can kind of do that in this too with, like, teleporting monsters and stuff, but that, I don't know that I would necessarily throw that on the same level. And it's some imps. That are, let's see how many words, how many ways I can mangle the statement, there are some imps, that are some imps, that is some imps. That's imps. I don't know. Ah, the elevator is my bro. It goes down right when I need it to. Alright. Easy peasy. Oh, oh, oh! Nice try, guys. We have a rocket launcher. I keep forgetting. I need to, like I said, I need to be careful with the rocket launcher because I'm as likely to kill myself with it as enemies. Like, the splash damage is no joke, and with my kind of penchant for strafing to the sides to avoid, like, things, I tend to, like, strafe sideways and fire a rocket at the same time into the wall that I'm strafing into for cover. And that's just kind of sadness. So, like, that guy right there, that guy was deaf because he didn't aggro onto me, even though I was shooting all these things, until I came around the corner and he had line of sight to me. That, no, there's no line deaths on the map. Although you can have hidden line deaths as well. Like, just because the map doesn't show any line deaths, that doesn't mean that there aren't any line deaths. Alright, so this looks like it was just kind of a little side area. That's actually something that I think... Oh, this is a bad idea. That's actually something that I think I need to work on in my maps, is that I think my maps tend to be... Oh, beautiful. My maps tend to be more or less completely functional maps, in that, like, every area that you go to on the map has a purpose for proceeding through the rest of the map. There's no just, like, here's a random little side area with, like, some ammo or something in it. And that is, I think, something that I should probably work on a little bit. And, like... Oh. Huh. And it kind of actually, now that I mention it, it kind of surprises me that I do that, considering I am a huge fan of games that have little side areas in maps like that. And, like, to me, that's something that, like, I always enjoy. It's like, oh, cool, it's a little side room with, you know, some environmental storytelling or, you know, whatever else. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and save here. And, is this gonna be a trap? No. Alright. Just come back to the beginning of the level to grab the key. Ah, it was a trap! Goddamn fucking... Of course. Of course! Because what else would it be? What else would it be? That's okay. We got some shotgun shells out of it. Some armor shards, some health. I should probably go trolling through some of the earlier parts of the level and see if there's any, like, health pickups that I missed, because we're not hurting, but we're not capped out on health and stuff. I think there might be some up here. We'll check this and then just kind of head towards progress. Eh, an armor shard. I'm hopeful that, whoa, hey, that with this episode, we'll be able to finish this episode, if that makes sense. We'll be able to finish Knee Deep in the Dead in this chunk of play here. I shouldn't say I'm hopeful. We will finish Knee Deep in the Dead in this chunk of play here. Doom is not a particularly long game. There are some parts of it that'll rustle jimmies, but overall, it's not huge. It's just replayable. Well, now how in the hell? Oh, it's probably through this blue door, huh? How do I get to that area through the door? God, I miss my double barrel shotgun so much. I'm not gonna spend this entire Let's Play whinging about my lack of a double barrel shotgun, but expect it to crop up every once in a while, at least. Because the single barrel is not bad, but the double barrel, it ain't. That thing is just so satisfying. Oh my lord. And if you've never played Doom, you need to go out and buy Doom and play it. Play through the first one, then play Doom 2, so that you can appreciate everything that Doom 2 does that Doom 1 doesn't. Including all of the horrible ways that it will find to kill you. That aren't just rocket accident related. I wanna get a rocket into that hallway back there, because... Yeah, there were a fair group of guys back here, now turned into some meaty pudding. I don't want that, but I want to know how to get out there. I have no idea. Did I just see critters? I did. Who called it? Who called that the first death was going to be self-inflicted rocket wound? I know. And it feels like we made a shot just like that earlier. Although, however, I feel less need now to play super safely now that we've died. It's like pulling off a band-aid. Except this one lets me fire rockets with impunity. Oh my god, you guys. Is that everybody? Anybody else? No? Good. Jesus. So I think we've been up there. Let's see, we move through here. Oh, that was... that was a waste. Oh, but I don't care. We have a lot of rockets. 25 rockets is a lot of rockets as far as I'm concerned, especially with the bestiary in this game. Like, this game doesn't have some of the really beefy monsters like Doom 2 does. It has some, but it doesn't have any, like, real equivalents to some of the bigger dudes in Doom 2. I'm trying to avoid using monster names until we encounter them on the off chance you are someone that has not played Doom. Because this is an older game, and I'm not gonna throw out that, like, you must be living under a rock if you've never played Doom. No, this game's going on, like, what, 30? God fucking damn it. This game's going on, like, 30. So, like, yeah, okay, there's gonna be people out there who've never played Doom. So I don't want to spoil things? You fuckers, though. I'm gonna go out and say hi to those guys. How do we do it? I were a secret door. Where would I be? I think it's a teleport to get out there. Because of that. Yeah, I can't hit this dude. He can hit me, though. Fucking cover, man. Not even once. That's okay. We'll pick him off. Is there anything along this wall? Oh, nice. All right, does this thing have a tell? Yeah, it does, like you can see. They doubled up on the texture there. God damn. I hate it, but I love it. Yay, we found partial invisibility. My life is better. More importantly, rock. Seriously? I came all this way just to kill these assholes with a rocket launcher, and I got nothing but disappointment for it. That's... Why would you do that? Like, even if your view were restricted to, like, normal view, you'd still be able to see that that doesn't have a back on it. I don't know. Maybe Xandronum just being weird, too. Like, that is always a possibility. Where's that damn door? Oh my god. Door. There we go. Alright. We want to go this way. Yeah, we're hurting. But that's okay, we gotta go fast. This is like high-level Path of Exile play. We just can't stop moving. Can't stop, won't stop. Gotta kill everything, gotta take everything. We got a secret, guys. Esports. And it only took us like 15 minutes. Oof. 10 minutes, but there was the death in there, so. Yeah. We are now into the Phobos Anomaly, which I believe is the final level of this one. Which... I think, goddammit. F5 for quick save, except F5 isn't a quick save here. Haha! The game just saved itself for me, but. Alright. I should have swapped over to a rocket launcher, but whatever. I think this is the boss. Our first boss. Which are known as the Bruiser Brothers. Feels like it. Is this like. Yeah, giant pentagram. Again, like the difference in the wall, you got like grime smeared. And they give us a supercharge. I should probably conserve my rockets now that I think about it. Not necessarily one for always being optimal. But in this case. Wow, we are like seriously capped out. Alright. This is a lot of build-up for a fight that honestly is not particularly difficult. He said moments before being eaten alive, but... Alright, these are the tombs of the Bruiser Brothers. And these are the Bruiser Brothers. There, this is... Ah, shit. Right, this, I can't tell if the ground is damaging me. I need to not... There we go. Okay, the ground is not damaging me. That's a shitload of specters. Alright, specter strats. Corner with a chainsaw. Well, maybe not. Okay, I wanna just unload on them with a rocket launcher. But, yeah, I was gonna say the rockets are just gonna blow right past. Yeah, these are barons of hell. I guess I can spoil some of the monsters from the later games, because, like, Doom 2 has a variant of the Baron of Hell called a Hell Knight, which is just a wimpier variant that they use to, like, give them, like, a filler, beefy but dangerous ranged monster. That doesn't feel too spoilery to me. All right, and that right there, that was the Bruiser Brothers boss fight. Like I said, not super bad. And they even give you, like, a partial invisibility over here because, hey, why not? See, we didn't even take any... No, we took some damage there. We got chewed on by pinkies a little bit. But nothing bad. Wait a minute. Oh, fuck. No! You can see on the minimap there's a little niche in one of those chambers where the Bruiser Brothers were. God damn it. I don't think we can get back up there either. I must know what the secrets are! Actually, it doesn't look like anything. It looks like just a wall. I don't know. It's probably something amazing. BFG 9000. Who knows? Let's go ahead and raise the stairs. Slowly. It's a nice mountainous terrain background there. Alright. And that was knee deep in the dead. Everything's terrible. What are we gonna do? Once you beat the big badasses and clean out the moon base, you're supposed to win, aren't you? Aren't you? Where's your fat reward and ticket home? What the hell is this? It's not supposed to end this way. It stinks like rotten meat, but looks like the lost Deimos base. Looks like you're stuck on the shores of hell. The only way out is through. To continue the Doom experience, play The Shores of Hell and its amazing sequel, Inferno. And with that, we are going to go ahead and call it an episode. And next time, we will be beginning The Shores of Hell. Until then.